Hello students, this is Chanel. Let us begin new chapter, Earth Pressure. So, Earth Pressure, that is pressure exerted by Earth, or we can say soil mass. Whenever the soil mass is exerting some pressure, it is termed as Earth Pressure. When we think about Earth Pressure, we get the first thought about retaining wall. So, let us start introduction of Earth Pressure. And then we will go to different theories. A retaining wall is used for maintaining the ground surfaces at different elevations on either side of it. You can see it in the picture. Retaining walls are generally used to maintain both the sides at different levels. So, let us understand retaining wall by its components. First of all, let us talk about backfill. So, the material which is retained or supported by the retaining wall, which is shown in the gray color, is known as backfill. Now, if the backfill is inclined at some angle, or we can say the backfill above the level of retaining wall is known as surcharge, and the regarding angle beta is known as surcharge angle beta. Same way, top portion of retaining wall is known as stem. In the bottom, now the front portion of the retaining wall is known as toe, and the back portion or bottom portion of retaining wall is known as heel. Now, you must have seen retaining walls on sites like parking of multi-story buildings, bridge sites retaining wall, as well as dam site retaining walls. There you must have seen gravels and sands lying behind the retaining wall, and this is the same kind of understanding of a retaining wall. Let us move further. Lateral earth pressure. Now, earth pressure which is lateral. Now, whenever the earth pressure is acting in a lateral or horizontal direction, it is known as lateral earth pressure. In the figure, you can see a retaining wall which is in a gray color. Now, in that, here green lines are showing ground line. So, this is a ground level and this is a retaining wall. So, retaining wall is retaining the earth behind that, right? Now, these blue lines are showing pressure diagram by these earths. Here, let us consider this level as H0. Total height is 0 at this. And coming down to this, the total height will become capital H. Let us understand pressure exerted by this soil on the retaining wall. So, the pressure is increasing as you increase its height. So, on H is equal to 0, there will be no pressure. But H is equal to H by 2, there will be some pressure. And H is equal to H, there will be some more pressure. Let us understand, this pressure is taken as P0. Now, P0 will act in a triangular shape due to its height. As we increase its depth, the pressure will increase. That is why it is in a triangular form, or we can say linear form. Now, this triangular pressure will act on its CG, or we can say the pressure is concentrated at center of gravity of retaining wall. And CG of retaining wall will be at H by 3, 1/3 of its height. So, this distance is assumed as H by 3. So, pressure is acting as P0 and acting at the height H by 3. Now, if we talk about pressure force, let us understand that pressure acting at the base of wall. So, pressure we have calculated Pa, that is Ka into gamma into H. Now, we know gamma, that is unit weight of soil mass, H, that is height of the soil mass. So, gamma into H into Ka, that is constant of active earth pressure. What is active earth pressure? you will get to know soon in the video. So PA is equal to KA into gamma into H. When we are talking about active voice pressure, we have to multiply it with KA. If we talk about pressure force, total force acting on the wall, it will be considered as pressure into area. Now, how the area should be calculated? The pressure is acting in the triangular form. So, we have to take 1 by 2 into height into base. So, base is the pressure, height is h. So, I am taking P0 as 1 by 2 K into gamma into h into h. That is why half K gamma h square will be my total force. Let us move further. Types of lateral earth pressure. So, lateral earth pressure is divided in three types. First type, there is active earth pressure. So, what is active earth pressure? Retaining wall moves away from the backfill. Then, earth pressure on the back of the wall increases and becomes maximum. And it is called active earth pressure. So, whenever the retaining wall and backfill are behaving as retaining wall moves away from the backfill, it is active earth pressure. Second case, when retaining wall moves towards backfill, that is the second former case, that is passive earth pressure. It will become minimum and that pressure is known as passive earth pressure. And the third type, earth pressure at rest, when the soil is acting as it is and no lateral pressure is provided, then total pressure will be known as earth pressure at rest. So, these are three types of earth pressure. Let us understand earth pressure failure envelope. Now, we know Mohr's stress. We remember that, right? So, let us understand active and passive earth pressure with Mohr's circle of stress. Here, you can see the first circle is showing active state of earth and Mohr's circle of stress for that. And second one is passive state circle for Mohr's circle. Here, the slip line going through this circle to the failure envelope line, the slip line going to the failure envelope line, which is tangential to the circle, is at the angle 45 minus pi by 2 for passive state and 45 plus pi by 2 at the active state. So, for active earth pressure failure, it will always occur at 45 plus pi by 2 angle, and for passive, it will act on 45 minus pi by 2. Let us move further. What is the difference between active and passive earth pressure? So, active earth pressure diagram will look like this and passive will look like this. Let us understand in more depth. So, these two diagrams are showing active and passive earth pressure. In case of lateral earth pressure, in active earth pressure, suppose this is a retaining wall and this is my backfill. Now, retaining wall will move away from the backfill, then it is active earth pressure, and if it moves towards the backfill, then it is passive earth pressure. So, these two diagrams are pretty clear about that. Let us understand that. These are failure planes shown in the figures. Now, failure plane will occur because of shear. Now, that shearing will happen how? Let us see that. Here, as it will move away from the backfill soil will try and move downwards and the resisting force will move upwards. So, it will make the soil fail, and failure angle will be 45 plus pi by 2 in the case of active earth pressure, and same happens in the passive case where the retaining wall will move towards backfill. So, the soil will move in the upward direction and resisting force will move in towards downwards direction, and that is how failure happen. And the angle will be 45 minus pi by 2. One more thing we can see, that is here sigma 1 and sigma 3 are shown in both of these figures. Now sigma 1 is major principal stress and sigma 3 is minor principal stress. We do remember that from stress distribution chapter as well as shear strength chapter. Now here in active earth pressure case, sigma h becomes minimum. That is why it is written in sigma 3 and sigma v will be constant. So this is what happens in active, where in passive sigma h becomes maximum and sigma v will be constant. So it becomes like this. So active and passive earth pressure can be divided like this. Now let us write technically. Wall moves away from backfill, then it is active earth pressure. Wall moves towards the backfill, then it is passive. Angle, that is 45 plus 5 by 2, 45 minus 5 by 2. Sigma h becomes minimum, sigma v remains constant. And here, sigma h becomes maximum and sigma v remains constant. Furthermore, Ka, that is coefficient of active earth pressure, is defined as sigma h by sigma v, where sigma h, as it is becoming minimum, it will be written as 1 minus sin phi upon 1 plus sin phi. Same way, Kp, coefficient of passive earth pressure, can be written as sigma h upon sigma v is equal to 1 plus sin phi upon 1 minus sin phi. K generally ranges between 0.3 to 0.45, where Kp ranges between 2 to 4. So this is basic difference between active and passive earth pressure. It is very important regarding exams. Moving further, one more earth pressure we have discussed, that is earth pressure at rest. So at rest, P0 will be pressure at original point at CG will be mu upon 1 minus mu. Mu is Poisson's ratio. And K0, coefficient of earth pressure at rest, will be 1 minus sin phi. So you should remember all coefficient as well as angles of failure planes. So let us keep our session up to this. We will learn new theories in the next video. Thank you.